Adrien, how was the press conference today? How would you conclude it?
It was cool. It was good.
You were very energized. You were shadow boxing. I've never seen a fighter shadow box at his own press conference.
I mean, I may be, man. I have fun, man. I like to have fun, man. Maidana, good fighter, hell of a fighter, world-class fighter. But it's levels to this shit. Like Meek Mill said, it's levels to this shit, man. He's not on my level.
Adrien, has there ever been a moment in your career where you've doubted your abilities?
No. No way. I don't even think I gave you all of my abilities yet. Maidana, he's a different type of fighter, and he might bring something else out of Adrien Broner that the world never seen. Or he might be a regular typical fighter after I make him look the way I'm gonna make him look. And he's going to be another nobody. Then he's going to have to go beat somebody who's supposed to be somebody for them to see that I didn't just beat a nobody. I made somebody look like a nobody, just like Pauly.
What did you say that I think might have been lost on a lot of people about fighters putting themselves on the line and thanking the fighters? Can you kind of go into detail about that, elaborate?
You know, even the fighters have to understand. You know, it's cool to thank your promoter and definitely your manager and your home team. But at the end of the day, nobody's going inside that ring and putting their body through what we put our body through. You know, we can die every night that we step inside that ring. We're really putting our life on the line in there. And I don't think we get in the type of respect that we should get.
Talk to me about that. What do you mean?
I mean, you think about it. You'll never know what a boxer put his body through. It's fighters who really starve themselves just to make weight. It's fighters who really go away from their family for months at a time. Gone away from your family, what, eight months out of a year? I mean, it's ridiculous. I mean, this is the stuff that the people don't know about boxers.
Keith Thurman called you out, and right now you and him were talking. Did you tell him anything?
No, he's doing his job. When I was young, I wanted to fight everybody who was on top because I didn't understand yet. I didn't understand boxing, but I always knew my time would come. And when they gave me my time, I took off.
So now that you're on top, is there anyone you want to fight down the line? Anyone on your list?
Listen, it don't matter who Adrien Broner fight. The world is going to watch because they want to see what Adrien Broner going
to
do.
But what's it going to take to bring out the best of you? What fighter is it going to take to bring out something we never seen?
Who knows, man? They say styles make fights. Who knows? Just know I will stay victorious. I will be victorious December 14th, and I'm going to put on a hell of a show.
What do you think about the rumors Floyd might fight Amir Khan? I'm just curious for your thoughts.
Well, you know, that's my big brother. He's going to do whatever he want to do, whatever fits his career. He's going to make the best decision for his career at the time. But right now I'm worried about Marcos Maidana, December 14th. And we'll talk to Big Bro after the fight.
How did you come up with anyone could get this? How does it go? Anybody could get this?
Anybody can get it. Africans, Mexicans. It don't matter. Anybody can get it. Puerto Rican. You know I'm a rapper, man.
Whoa. We almost had an accident here.
Why do you love the spotlight so much? What is it about this that you crave?
Like they say, everybody's not born to be a star. You got people who just want to make a lot of money and sit in the back and be comfortable. Well, I love money and I love being a star.
But since you became a star, do you notice like a lot of hangers-on, people who want a slice of that fame and aren't genuine with their friendship?
It comes with the territory. You're going to have people who love you, you're going to have people who hate you.